hi, I'm Ida.
And I'm Mia from Crucified Barber.
Yeah, no, I think what attracts all teenagers, you want excitement and you want to try something that you never experienced before. And I used to go to this youth center and everybody was playing the pool and doing stupid games, and we had basically nothing to do. And it was a rehearsal place with a lot of different instruments, but nobody wanted to play the bass. So I ended up playing the bass. But in afterwards, I understand that I made a good choice, but I think it was just being a teenager and having nothing to do. And
there, like rock music.
Yeah, and exactly, listen to a lot of records. And I think it was just a natural development. You started playing your instrument, and then of course you wanted to start a band. That's the coolest thing on earth, to have a band. And so we just got together, a couple of friends, and we played in many different constellations before we met each other. So I think it's quite natural. You play an instrument, then you want to have a band. You want to play rock and be on a stage.
But for me it was quite a big change, because before the only music thing I was singing choir in school, like when I was really young. And my mother forced me to play the accordion, you know. And I didn't really like it. So then when I was 14, at the same age we all started to listen to rock music, I got into Nirvana, and I tried like acoustic guitar for the first time, and I can play the songs on Nirvana, my favorite band. That's the start.
We are going to in September, I think. We're gonna write as many as possible, but I think we got quite a lot of songs by now. But we need to make the final adjustments and all the arrangements so that it gets like to the best version of the songs.
Yeah, we played one new song tonight, but this morning, we don't even know if that's gonna be on the album or not, but we hope so. But yeah. Now I know what I must do.
Fantastic.
No matter what, it's always great to be in France. And everybody home in Sweden is like, what's going on in France? Why are you here so often? And because, first of all, we have a great booking agent and label here. So, but the audience is great and it's so fun. And today it was fantastic.
And everybody's really friendly, coming with small gifts and like t-shirts and a bottle of wine and stuff.
Likes the gifts.
Yes. No, but it's nice. People are really nice here in France, and so we have a good audience here, and we love France. Oh, okay. We don't really have a form when we write songs. It can be.
That's why it takes 4 years.
Yeah, it, a lot of different ways. Sometimes one person writes a whole song, and other times we get just a riff and we do the song in the rehearsal place all together. And sometimes you have like half a song ready and you send it to another because you can't really proceed in the song, and somebody else picks it up and makes a great melody for the chorus or something. So we don't really have a certain form. Everybody's involved.
Yeah.
Mainly Mia.
Yeah, I write most of it because I have to sing it, so it's natural. But I ask everybody for input and own ideas. So if someone has a lyric, something they want, bring it on.
Yeah, but I think it's important that you feel like, as a singer and of course as the band, that you feel like you can really relate to the lyrics, and you feel that it's that you mean it,
yeah,
what you sing. Tomorrow we hope.
As soon as possible after New Year, like next year in the early spring, hopefully. It depends on the label and when they want to release it, but I think yeah, early spring, 2012.
Yeah, we're writing songs and playing some festivals and hanging out.
Yeah, we have a few, like 6 or 7, mostly in Sweden. We come back to France again on the 20th of August to Brittany.
Brittany.
French.
Yes. And yeah, then we're gonna focus on the album, so. I don't really, for me as a songwriter, I don't have a, I can't mention any influences right now because I just get ideas of lyrics, what I want to sing, and then I get melodies like in my head, and then I try to put music to it. I don't get like some band or some song that I want to do a song like this. It's just lyrics and melodies that I put.
But then I think you can, you look at a movie or you listen to a song or you experience something, and then that like gets stuck in your head, and you can write a song about that if it fits.
If it affects you,
yeah. I think you get affected by everyday life and you get affected by many stuff, but movies and literature and other bands are a big influence. Clutch for me. Yesterday I only saw a couple of songs, but Clutch. And no, I saw 2 songs, but then we had to leave for the hotel. But that's, I love Clutch. But I think all of us likes Creator. I think we're gonna watch a bit of Creator tonight. And then I wanted to see The Haunted. I love The Haunted, but The Haunted from Gothenburg. Yeah, but they canceled because I think the singer. He missed his flight, so they're gonna play tonight. So we were going up on stage.
They're coming.
Yeah, I think he's coming. We went up on stage and like, what is this? This is not The Haunted. It's something completely different. So I looked forward to see The Haunted, but. Ooh, that's a hard question. Of course you don't like it because you play music with all your heart and it feels like somebody's stealing a bit from you.
I don't think that's the problem, but it's the what heter det?
Attitude.
The attitude of the young audience that expect everything for free. That causes problem for It's not that you download a song for free or something. I do it as well sometimes.
I think what you mean is that their way of looking at music is that everything should be free and you can download anything you want. You don't have to pay for anything.
In the end it's going to be a problem for the bands that's making the music. So free illegal downloading is in the end it's not a good thing.